watching God's Word for You Today program, an online Bible teaching ministry of Maranatha Baptist Church, Villamonte, Bacolod City, Philippines. This program is designed to make the time-tested, solid Word of God relevant to your life's need today. God's Word for You Today is found in...
If you then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ seated on the right hand of God. Set your affection on the things above, not on the things on the earth. So out of this passage, we will entitle our lesson, The Life That Is Resurrected with Christ. So again, no, kabalo kita that the whole theme of the book of Colossians is to emphasize the sufficiency of Christ. So, sina nga theme, makita nato, no, si Apostle Pablo nag-introduce, gin-describe niya kung ano klase ang nga kabuhi nga na-resurrect o pod kay Jesus. Ang bali Pablo, if you then be risen with Christ, dua kumandra, seek those things which are above and set your affection on things above. So, that's the life that is resurrected with Christ. So, hindi pwede nga ara kay Jesus, wala epekto, wala result. Because Jesus is sufficient for our salvation, ano dapat ang effect sa tanan nga ara siya? So, amo nang gustong emphasize ni Apostle Pablo, no, sa sininga passage. So, number one, ano ang unang picture sang life that is resurrected with Christ? Number one, what is the command? Ang bali Pablo, seek the things of God. So, muna ang balsang sang verse, no? Verse number one, if you then be risen with Christ. So, before ko na-emphasize na yung inyong mga commands, gusto ko anay emphasize ang phrase nga, if you then be risen or if ye then be risen with Christ. Ano ang butsing ko sinang phrase? It means that those who are united in Christ. It means, kung nabuhi ka upod kay Jesus, another way of saying, na-resurrect ka upod kay Jesus, you have life with Christ. In short, you are a believer. You have a personal relationship with Christ. So, si Pablo, no, kontra naton, nga confidence si Pablo, nga maghatag sang command, no, nga seek and set your affection. Kay, kabalo si Pablo, naturally, kung ikaw, no, ara ka Jesus, ma-resulta, kag ma-epekto sa imo gidya, no, nag-seek ka, kag ginaset mong imo affection, to the things above. So, nagsugod si Pablo sa phrase nga, if you then be risen with Christ. So, ang inang phrase ga signify, if anyone has a personal relationship with Christ. In short, if you have life with Christ, you have been risen with Christ. So, ano ang natural nga effect? Nag-seek ka sa mga butang nga ara sa babaw, kag ginaset mo ang imong affection on the things above. So, amo na ang makita nato nga point. Okay, so balik ato sa phrase, no, if you then be risen with Christ, and then connected da ang dua ka command, seek the things of God and set your affection. Okay, so ang word nga seek, no, kiambala ni Pablo, no, seek the things above. So ang word nga seek, no, nga connected sa seek those things which are above, ang word nga seek, that's a command, imperative, meaning ga requires ang obedience. Seek, when say seek, meaning to worship or to desire. So, it has to do with a passion, no? Has to do with a passion, to seek, to worship, or to desire. Anong i-desire mo? The things which are above. Ang mga butang nga ara sa babaw, makita na karon, no? Ano ang mga butang nga ara sa babaw? Kay gin connect da, where Christ seated at the right hand of God. So, ano ang busing mo sang phrase nga, seated at the right hand of God. No, Jesus sitting at the right hand of God. Ang ina nga phrase nga, emphasize ang that Jesus is ruling or siya ang nag-control. It means that the focus of one's desire is Jesus. So, Jesus must be the focus of our desire. Seek the things which are above where Christ seated at the right hand of God. In short, Jesus must be the focus of our desire to seek the things of God. In short, seek Jesus personally. So, ikadua, no, magalit sa to sa pamangkot, how do we know that we are seeking Christ? actually connected sa ikaduha kuman. Again, specify sa aton, kaya hindi naman makita si Jesus. Ang bali Pablo, no, under sa life that is resurrected with Christ, ikaduha kuman, setting one affection to the things above. Kaya ang bali Pablo, set your affection on the things above. Set your affection. So that's another command, imperative. Again, ga requires ang obedience. So connected sa gina sa nagasik ka kay Jesus. How do we know? You are setting your affection on the things above. That's a present tense, meaning continue to set your affection on the things above. Kaginaan mo man na ang tense sa verb nga seek, meaning continue to seek. This time, continue to set our affection on the things above. So that's a present tense. And when one's affection is being nourished with the things above, kay kulang taon nato no, gahatang mas ang idea sa aton nga inourish ta. Ang aton nga, kay ang desire or affection has to do with the mind. Meaning, no, ang imo nga unod sa imo nga mind. So, kag gina heart or desire or passion, this time naman niya, ang word nga affection, no, to exercise the mind. Meaning has to do with the mind. Ang ginanourish naton sa na-resurrect kita kay Jesus, sa nabuhi kita upod sa iya, inourish naton sa mga butang nga iya sa babaw. Setting one's affection to the things above. And when one's affection is being nourished with the things above, gina-reflect naton ang character sa Dios. Ang verse gambal sa aton, set your affection on the things above, not on the things on the earth. So, busilingon, sa nabuhi ka kapod kay Jesus, inourish na ang mind ta, kang ang heart ta, sa mga butang nga iyasang babaw. In contrast with the things of the earth. Ano ang mga butang nga iyasang sa duta out sa earth? Ang bali Pablo, mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, sa verse 5, evil concupiscence, and covetousness, which is idolatry. In short, amo na mga butang nga iyasang sa dalom on the earth. So hindi tayo pag-entertain na. Instead, set your affection on the things above, not on the things on the earth. So in contrast, ano yang dapat nga isek naton, kag-desire naton, as one way nga pagkita naton, nga gina-nourish naton ang life naton nga na-resurrect upon kay Jesus. Ang bali Pablo, verse 8, but now ye also put off all this: anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Verse 9, lie not one to another, and seeing that you have put off the old man with his deeds, and have put on the new man, which is renewed in the knowledge after the image of him that created him. As the elect of God, be holy, beloved, bowels of mercy, kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, long-suffering, forbearing one another. In short, amunin contrast sang on things of the earth. In short, mapakita naton nga ginanourish naton ang aton nga life nga na-resurrect upon kay Jesus, we seek and we set our affection. Paano naton nga pagkita ginanourish naton? Gina-reflect naton ang character sang Dios. In short, no, these two imperatives emphasize that the focus of the whole being of a believer must be the things related to God. Kag ano na, paano mamakita nga ginanourish naton ang life naton sa mga butang iya sang Dios? Gina-reflect ang character sang Dios, giving attention to it, tagaan ta value attention. In this crisis, no, ang kalibutan gambal sa aton, ang pinakaimportante nga imuunta nga ma-survive kita sa sininga crisis, sa sininga COVID. But the Bible is telling us, as we Christians, the Bible is telling us that the renewed character is the most valuable thing in life. Ang renewed character, the more crisis nga na-experience yan ta, dapat ang aton nga character ang kakadevelop, gina-reflect ang character sa Dios, nga naging merciful kita, naging honest kita. Amuna ang way naton nga mapakita nga gina-nourish ta ang life naton nga na-resurrect upon kay Jesus, we seek and we set our affection. Paano nato mapakita nga ginamutan ang ginaobra ta, nga ginaobey ta? Gina-reflect ang character sa Dios. Hindi busilingong galing nga crisis pag gusto nato sa life ta. Instead, out of this crisis, mapakita tang character tang gina-nourish naton, gina-reflect ang character sa Dios sa ato niya nga kabuhi. Amuna ang valuable thing nga ma-importante nga mahimo naton out of this passage. That is God's word for you today.